she knows, milestones and local heroes. Sports, shorts, event reports, news you'll use of every sort.
Celebrations and on location.
Plugged In, the TV show with what you want to know, what you need to know, and what you'd like to know about what's going on in your town this week.
It's Plugged In. Plugged into your life. Plugged into here and now.
Get Plugged In on your local cable station.
It's Saturday. Hooray, hooray. Hope you're enjoying the weekend. It's a good one out there. Time for us to plug you in here on Rogers. We've got all sorts of interesting stories about what's happening in your communities around Simcoe Gray. So sit back and enjoy the next 30 minutes. We'll have your local environment, weather forecast, and much more. Stay tuned. Plugged In is next here on Rogers Community TV.
A short drive to the store or a long drive in the country, Tom Smith Chevrolet will get you there. Trucks, you won't be out of luck once you cruise the lot at Tom Smith Chevrolet. And cars, you won't have to look far for those either at Tom Smith Chevrolet. Tom Smith Country, Chevrolet, Oldsmobile, Chevy Trucks on King Street in Midland. Proud to sponsor Plugged In Tuesday through Saturday at 6:30 p.m.
You're watching Rogers Community TV, serving the communities of Simcoe Gray.
And welcome to the Saturday edition of Plugged In here on Rogers Community TV. I'm your host, Valerie Cruz. On the program tonight, we have stories from Collingwood, Owen Sound, and Wasaga Beach. And we have the Environment Canada weather forecast for the South Georgian Bay Area. So please stay plugged in with us. We begin our show tonight with a story from the Owen Sound area. I'm sure that most of you have heard of the death of Wyerton Willie earlier this week. It came as a huge shock to Groundhog fans and a blow to the Wyerton area. But Groundhog Day started well before Willie was around. Mark Perry brings us the story.
Wyerton Willie was 22 years old when he died, but Groundhog Day has been going for over 40 years. It was all started by Oliphant resident Mac McKenzie.
Well, I go back now to the period in the 1960s, some 40 more years ago. And it so happened I was born and brought up in Oliphant, a summer resort north of Sable Beach. And many of my friends who had cottages there had never seen their cottage in the wintertime. So I decided we would have a little party up here in the wintertime. And so we got some rooms at the local hotel, and we decided it would be a groundhog festival. And the Toronto Star somehow heard about it and sent a reporter up to cover it. And he came motoring blithely into town and asked, "Where's the festival?" And local merchants, puzzled, said, "We don't know of any festival. There are a bunch of guys that'll tell him having a good time." So the reporter went down. He was the late Frank Teske, a reporter, photographer, Toronto Star, and joined us. And so we partied on, and the Sunday morning came. He said, "I can't go back without a story of some kind." So we borrowed Susie Smiley's fur hat, took it over and put it in a snowdrift with a button facing out like an eye, and we were duly photographed looking at our first groundhog. Was named after the comic strip character in Pogo called Grundoon. So we posed looking at Grundoon coming forth to see his shadow, and that appeared in the Toronto Star, and that was back in the 60s, and that was the beginning of it all. The next year, we borrowed a stuffed groundhog from the University of Guelph, which was then the OAC, and he was named a more local name. He was called Sandoon, and his brother Muldoon, and they were all stuffed. But they became the beginning of what is today the well-known Wyerton Willie Festival. Now, Wyerton Willie, by the way, is, of course, a white groundhog with pink eyes. The pink eyes, of course, resemble most of the celebrants around here today after the weekend like this. But the point is that albino groundhogs are rare, but they do exist, and our Wyerton Willie is one of those.
Groundhog Day has since grown into a weekend-long festival attracting thousands to the small town on the Bruce Peninsula.
We started off with a hockey tournament, curling bonspiel. There was a prom fashion show, a parade, smooch races, fish fries, dances, children's road hockey tournament, penny carnival. There was a teen dance, I'm trying to think of all, and there was about 50 or 60 events, so it's kind of tough to get them all. But everything went really, really well. We just went hog wild in Wyarton.
It is so popular, a call center set up to field calls from around the world to find out the prediction of six more weeks of winter or not.
Good morning, Groundhog Central.
Okay.
CIGB That's Radio fine. In Penticton?
Yeah. Rita.
Uh-huh. No, but I can help you.
No, not at all. Yes, we have actually. Yeah.
4:10 in the morning. Yeah, you can. We've got 6:50 out here.
There's a lot to the festival, culminating with the prediction of the weather forecasting groundhog. The committee is looking at making it even bigger. It is a boom to the town of South Bruce Peninsula. And don't worry, Wyarton Willie will have a successor by next year's festival. For Plugged In Wyarton, Mark Perry reporting.
Thanks, Mark. The town of Wasaga Beach kicked off the weekend Winterfest today with plenty of great winter events. The Ontario Federation of Snowmobile Clubs Sled Smart team was there to promote safe sledding. We caught up with the team at the clubhouse of the Wasaga Beach Snowmobile Club today to hear what they had to say.
Hi there, I'm Cynthia Hodgson with the Sled Smart Education Team with the Ontario Federation of Snowmobile Clubs. We're here at the Wasaga Snowmobile Club at their annual Family Fun Poker Run, and we're here with Ron Pardon. He's one of the staff officers today. And Ron, can you just tell us a little bit about what you do?
Well, we actually do, we have the same powers basically as OVP in the Unmotorized Snow Vehicle Act, and we patrol the trails on a fairly regular basis. Just trying to more or less, get people to just, slow it down a little bit, take it a little easier.
Okay.
And have a good day out of it.
Great. So it's most often it's safety that you're looking for out there on the trails. And is there anything else that you're looking for?
Safety is a big factor, no doubt about that. Stolen sleds, that type of thing. We're looking for that type of stuff too. So.
Okay. I know the Sled Smart team, we have four main messages that we're trying to get out to snowmobile enthusiasts. One being, know before you go, always check your local ice conditions, especially when we're given the weather conditions that we're dealing with right now. You can never trust that ice is going to be 100% safe. When night riding, slow down. The other one is ride safe, stay on the trail. And the last one, of course, is the don't drink and ride.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're looking for snowmobile theft at times. Is there anything that you would recommend for people to do to try and help from their sleds being stolen?
Well, they should use something like this here, throttle cup, they call it, and that way you can put it on the end of the handlebar, and you lock it on, it prevents the throttle being opened up. There's other things out there too. This is a pretty good device here.
Okay, who's that made by?
Easy Tracks,
okay, great. Thank you very much, Ron.
Yep.
I'm here now with Constable Mike Lachance. And Mike, just tell us a little bit about what you do.
I look after the STOP program. I'm the STOP coordinator on the OPP side. There's a STOP coordinator with the OPP, and there's one with the Ontario Federation Snowmobile Clubs, and we work in conjunction together.
Great, okay. We're sort of focusing today a little bit about snowmobile theft, and what would you suggest for people to do to prevent that from happening?
Well, one of the simple things is, first of all, when you have it parked anywhere, make sure you take your keys with you. Mm-hmm. A lot of people actually still leave them out. Mm-hmm. Maybe just take a few seconds and pop your hood up and turn the gas off or undo one of the plugs. It only takes a few minutes, but at least it deters the individual. He'll have to go out of his way a little bit to actually do something to get it going.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe just another tip is if you have your snowmobile at home, mm-hmm. Make sure that you don't leave it on the trailer. Put it in your garage, mm-hmm. chain it down. Just do something that deters the individual. He'll have to actually work at it to get it. Just don't make it too easy for them.
Right. One other thing that the Sled Smart team, we actually lock our trailer as well. And I'm Cynthia Hodgson again, and we're at the second annual Ryan's Run with the Wasaga Snowmobile Club. Thank you.
Good to see the weather help with the fun at Wasaga Beach this weekend. In Collingwood, more federal funding was announced yesterday to do some research into the old Collingwood grain elevators and its suitability for the future. The landmark building is part of the Harbourland development, and Collingwood Mayor Terry Geddes has more in this report.
Hello, here we are down at the Spit, also called the Harbourlands of the Municipality of the Town of Collingwood. Right behind me, we have the grain elevators, one of the heritage monuments in this municipality. I have with me today people who have been instrumental in a feasibility study for the grain elevators. And the first person I'd like to talk to is the person who's brought the Town of Collingwood a check for $37,300. Mr. Paul Bonwick, the MP for this area.
Thanks, Terry.
Paul, can you tell us how this came about?
Yeah, certainly. After meetings with the Collingwood Harbourlands Committee and yourself, of course, Director of Parks and Rec Peter Dunbar, they identified that one of the key areas they wanted us to focus in on for funding was the Harbourlands itself. And so at that point in time, I contacted John Pinder from Human Resource Development Canada and asked him to set up a meeting with councillors responsible, councillors Foley and Cooper and Peter Dunbar, to investigate possible sources of funding where we could play a role in assisting the town with some costs. And one of the things that has come out of this is the grain elevators. As you're aware, it's a landmark not just for Collingwood, but in fact Georgian Bay. And so the feasibility study, I think, will provide an excellent opportunity for the town to go out and market it and get that property developed.
Paul, we were looking for something around $25,000. How were you able to come up with $37,000?
Well, we've got to give John credit for that, actually. The town originally was looking for something around $27,000, and Councillor Foley and I had chatted on a couple of occasions about it, and certainly he had suggested that he would be prepared to come forward to the council and ask them to put some money in as well, and John was able to source out some additional funds, so we're hoping that the federal government will be able to pick up the entire cost of the project at this point.
John, congratulations on doing that. What do you see as the Human Resources Canada's role in this, and how can you give us a secret how you found that extra $10,000?
No secrets. Well, basically, we're involved with community partnerships, and with the Town of Collingwood being a partner, what we're looking at is community development and ultimately jobs that may become as a result of doing something with the terminals, and I believe that's what our biggest interest is. The funds, well, basically, funds are available, and as we get down to our year end, which is March 31st, we're able to look around to other communities that may not have spent their funds and secure them that way, and that's how we came about it.
John and Paul, on behalf of Collingwood, once again, thank you for your continued support of our municipality. Keep the money coming, Paul. I've got with me also Councillor Sonny Foley and Councillor Sandra Cooper, and they've been very instrumental in what you see happening down around the entire Harbourlands. Sonny, you must be very happy with this.
Yes, and part of the funding, for those that don't know, is to go and do a structural study of the terminal to see how structurally sound it is and what could be added and contributed to it. And the second part of the study will be to go out into the world, if you will, and see what opportunities for use we can put to it based on the strength that is in the facility. So,
Sandra, in your comments?
Yes, I'm pleased to be a part of the Harbourlands Committee. I'm very proud of Collingwood with our heritage at the waterfront, and I'm very pleased with the grant that we've received today in order to move ahead on our terminals and look at some future projects and perhaps run into the millennium and really show off a gem in our community.
Councillors Foley and Cooper have certainly summed it up for each and every one of us. The millennium's coming. We're going to ensure that our terminals stay, and if anything else, we're going to ensure that they have a real reason to be. Thank you.
Thanks, Terry. In the Grey Bruce area, volunteers are making a difference in support for abused women. Paul Van Wyk spoke to some of the organizers of the Women's Center in Owen Sound about the type of services offered at the shelter.
Sexual assault and wife abuse can be very traumatic experiences, but the women's shelter of Grey and Bruce and their volunteers are trying to make it a little bit easier to get through.
It's very difficult for women to go through any services after being assaulted because it's a difficult issue. Women underreport sexual assault. It's very, it's one of the most underreported crimes. Secondly, it's very, very difficult to prosecute, so it's very difficult for this woman to understand why. So there is quite a bit of turmoil around that. I can't say one way or the other. Our agency just provides options for the woman and gives her as much information as we can so that she can make an informative choice.
Our greatest need of support from volunteers in Gray County and on the peninsula is in the emergency transportation program. Most often, this is women's first link to our services across Gray and Bruce counties, and that's one of the ways that they remain isolated is by not having transportation of their own. So we're always in need of volunteer drivers across all of the areas. The services we provide help many, many women across Gray and Bruce counties, both through the sexual assault center services, the community counseling services, the crisis line, and through the shelter. The shelter itself is a 10-bed shelter, meaning that we can have 10 women and or children in the shelter at a time. And women and their children can stay there for up to approximately 28 days. And in that time, we're assisting them in finding a new home and getting other supports into place that they need.
Volunteers work on the helpline. They are trained, well-trained, and are able to answer calls to women from Gray and Bruce counties 24 hours a day. Also use volunteers for secretarial work and the library and any other volunteer capacity that is acceptable and we are able to train for.
The Women's Center is helping women through a tough time in their lives. And if you'd like to help them out by becoming a volunteer, you can phone the Sexual Assault Center in Durham at 369-6633, the Women's Shelter in Owen Sound at 371-5549, or you can stop by the Volunteer Center at Heritage Place Mall. For Plugged In, I'm Paul Vanek reporting.
Thanks, Paul. Now it's time for the Rogers Top 10 Video Rentals that you can pick up at your neighborhood Rogers Video Store.
Hi, I'm Ryan from Rogers with your weekly top 10 list. Number 10, we have disturbing behavior. Number 9 is knock off. Number 8 is 54. Number 7 is blade. Number 6 is dance with me. Number 5 is lethal weapon 4. Number 4 is out of sight. Number 3 is 6 days, 7 nights. Number 2 is Mafia. And the top number 1 release this week is still Truman Show with Jim Carrey. I also want to tell you about some new releases that we have. We now have Rush Hour with Jackie Chan and Chris Tucker, a new action flick. It's very exciting, very action-packed. And if you're a big Jackie Chan fan, I'd recommend this one tremendously. And also we have Something About Mary with Cameron Diaz that came out this Tuesday. For everyone who's been asking about it, come in, get this movie. It's very funny.
They're two cops with nothing in common.
Do it again. Like this.
Except the case.
Hello, you have one more chance.
They can't walk away from.
Agent Carter is very passionate about finding your daughter.
Which one of y'all kick me?
From New Line Cinema.
Come on.
The fastest hands in the East.
Wow.
Meet the biggest mouth in the West.
Just received a threat on the building. We ask you please exit the building. Do not panic. Do you hear what I just said? Go over the building.
Jackie Chan.
I can't hold that anymore.
Just hang on, man. I'll be right back.
Chris Tucker.
FBI. emergency. It's okay. Wait a minute.
Rush Hour.
Be sure to stay tuned to Plugged In. Coming up next, we have the Environment Canada weather forecast. We'll be right back.
At Rogers, we know you don't just watch TV. You read, you surf, you stay in touch. It's why you've got to become a VIP member. You won't just save real money on cable. You'll save 10% on Rogers at Home, Cantel AT&T Cellular, AT&T Canada Long Distance, and more. The VIP program. Only we could put something like this together, but only someone like you can appreciate it. You're not going to miss all this, are you? Nothing is too big or too small, and where you are matters more than where you're from. 30 years ago, Rogers created community television to cover the things that happen close to home, to cover the places where we meet and talk, places where anything can happen. Because in this part of television land, you don't have to be famous to be important. This part of television land, small doesn't mean insignificant. A little determination goes a long way. And you just never know when you'll rub elbows with immortality. 30 years ago, Rogers created community television to cover the things that happen close to home. Because in this part of television land, big things happen in small places.
Classroom. Commercial-free educational television programming provided to schools as a public service by Canadian cable companies. Cable in the Classroom tears down walls, opens minds.
Straight shooting.
It's like we don't agree about nothing about this guy. You like him, I don't.
Hard hitting.
I think Jack Nicholson was right. You people can't take the truth.
On the mark.
Deluded? The minute she turns south and becomes a state's witness, she's deluded.
Hardball with Chris Matthews. Targeting the people with the power.
I think a lot of liberals said, who's he to be Speaker of the House?
And the games they play to get there. Hardball with Chris Matthews. Weeknights, 8 Eastern and Pacific, only at CNBC.
Welcome back to Plugged In. The Environment Canada weather forecast for our viewing area tonight calls for cloudy with possible light snow overnight, low to -6. Sunday will be mainly cloudy with scattered flurries in the morning, becoming sunny in the afternoon, low near -6, high near -1. Monday will be mainly cloudy and milder with wet flurries or showers, low near -5 and a high near +2. The outlook to Tuesday could be variable cloudiness and mild, lows near -4 and a high near +3. The probability of precipitation is 50% tonight, 40% for Sunday, and 70% for Monday. The wet weather is here for a little while, but that's a sign that spring could be just around the corner. I like that. Spring can't come too soon for me.
out of the family for some animated fun with one of the most lovable characters from children's literature. This pigtailed firecracker is sure to bring fun for the whole family. Then Barbara Streisand and Richard Dreyfuss star in this classic drama about a woman who's charged with manslaughter. Tensions mount when it comes time for her to take the stand. Teletoon has Pippi Longstocking at 7:30 and WTN has Nuts at 8. Catch it on Rogers tonight.
Snowmobiles are great fun, but problems can arise when they're not driven responsibly. Riding late at night in residential areas is inconsiderate, and loud exhausts and unnecessary engine revving can be very annoying. If you ride off trails, you upset property owners and run the risk of having the access privileges revoked and the trail being closed to all sledders. Please tone it down, stick to the trails, and help conserve Ontario's last frontier. A message from the Ontario Federation of Snowmobile Clubs Environment Committee.
Classroom. Commercial free educational television programming provided to schools as a public service by Canadian cable companies. Cable in the classroom tears down walls, opens minds.
For more than 900 years.
116 years in Canada, whenever the need is there.
So are we. And now, looking forward.
Facing tomorrow.
One thing remains the same.
The caring faces of St. John Ambulance.
Thanks to your support, your caring, your donations.
We'll face whatever the future holds.
Put yourself in the picture.
Face the future with us.
Be one of the many faces of St. John Ambulance.
That's our show for this evening. Thanks for staying plugged into your community here on Rogers Community TV. For Plugged In, I'm Valerie Cruz. Have a great evening and a great weekend. Good night.
Whether it's a short drive to the store or a long drive in the country, Tom Smith Chevrolet will get you there. Trucks, you won't be out of luck once you cruise the lot at Tom Smith Chevrolet. And cars, you won't have to look far for those either at Tom Smith Chevrolet. Tom Smith Country, Chevrolet, Oldsmobile, Chevy Trucks on King Street in Midland. Proud to sponsor Plugged In Tuesday through Saturday at 6:30 p.m.